I'm on the negative side, opposing the affirmative claim that terminally ill patients receiving physician assisted suicide should be able to receive physician assisted suicide, sorry. So to begin with, a study done by healthresearchfunding.org a report prepared by U.S. Health Division stated that little to no patients who requested physician-assisted suicide had uncontrolled pain, and according to their reports, all patients who requested this procedure said it was due to social concerns. Another study done by Lasalit.org said that advances in pain management and hospice care make it possible to treat pain and to give the dying patient more choices. My opponent did say that it was a safe method of suicide. The laws enacted in Washington and Oregon regarding physician-assisted suicide don't require witnesses to be present when lethal doses of medicine are administered. Some have some citizens have criticized this part of the law, stating that it may lead to abuses or especially elder abuse or the administering of this procedure without a patient's proper consent. The most obvious reason is due to lack of oversight when the lethal injection is administered to the patient. Another point is that patients could recover. Every good doctor knows that medicine is an art as well as a science. No one can predict 100% certainty who will live and who will die. As an example, a mistake in misdiagnose that happened in Mississippi. The Mississippi Supreme Court upheld a $4 million award to a family of a woman misdiagnosed with cancer and then given a lethal injection of painkillers. The 66-year-old woman received a massive dose of painkillers at a hospice for cancer, which an autopsy showed that she never had cancer, according to the court records. This is one example of the abuse that could happen with the not overviewing, like the lethal injections are not properly seen. Another point that my opponent brought up, for assisted suicide shouldn't be anyone's first choice. Note that 44 million Americans don't have health insurance, and that medicine sometimes practiced in hospitals is sometimes against minorities. Thus, they argue that the last to receive medicine is the first to receive assisted suicide. Insurance companies should pay. Denying or delaying treatment to save money already proposes a significant danger. For example, in Oregon, as my partner said here, two Oregon citizens were informed that their health plan and many other insurance health plans don't cover chemotherapy or proper treatment for their sicknesses, but do cover assisted suicide costs. So, not only are patients pressured into assisted suicide because they feel like they're a pressure on their family, but also physicians could be pressured into going towards assisted suicide because insurance companies and money and like government controls